Alright, so I know it's very exciting lately. I'm gathering this Gedcom. I'm working with the Python. And I made it through. I got this little script program written by Fontaine, Benoit Fontaine. So it's very interesting because I'm a Fontaine also. So the programmer who wrote the program is a faraway Fontaine. So that's very neat. Anyway, I got it to work. And it's a script that goes to Family Search and then it pulls out the data. And I worked a lot at it because you have to go into the raw files. You can't use the one that's Fresh Express. You have to go through the raw files and figure out which one was the one that's the fresh raw. And in the beginning, see, I'm such a dum-dum. I'm like, well, there's the bug. A fix, and so I went to my program and I started fixing the bugs on my program, and I started doing line for line, and then I'm like, Later on, I started to realize that you don't have to do it that way. You can go to a more recent one and try to use that one, and chances are you'll be lucky. So yeah, because there were just hundreds of bug fixes. But it was good for me. It's still a mind exercise, isn't it? Even to make a mistake, it's a mind exercise because you learn how the process of bug fixing is, and it's not a fun job for anybody to actually do that. So I've got that, and drama after drama after drama. You take a grandparent and you get their line, you take another one and you get their lines. And I'm like, well, okay, this is fabulous, except they're all huge files, you know, they're all over 100 megabytes. And I'm like, well, if I have them over 100 megabytes, I'll merge them, right? And so I went out there and I tried to find mergers. And they don't have mergers. I could not merge my grandparents. I couldn't, all four. I couldn't find any mergers that were readily available. So I'm like, well, then forget it. Then I'll go ahead and I'll download again, you know, just from myself as the main poodle. And then, what that means is that consolidated them. So I consolidated them all into one file, but it's still 120 megabytes or so. I mean, it goes back to Constantine, so it's a very, very large file. It's wonderful though. It's a historic value. And so I'm like, well, great. So now I have this file. I'm using Gramps also at the moment, which is for Linux machine. It's a very good one for the genealogy. If you want to list by locations in the world, it'll show up all the locations of the people, where they were. If you want to list by group sets of, you know, these types of family, you know, for just one particular name, and they are sorted relatives, so it has all kinds of good little things like that. But the geography one is amazing because it actually does have a map, and it puts them all over on this map. So I'm very, very happy with the program. However, it doesn't have the merge feature. So if you have two Gedcoms, you can't really merge it. It's more like you'd have to use a plugin, and even then, I believe it's that the old type of merger where it's one record at a time. The MyHeritage site does a merge, an automatic merge, and I believe genie.com also, but those ones are more like you have to pay money for that action. And I'm not sure you can download it after, you know, like after you've merged it all together. I'm not sure you can download that file. So you kind of have to, at this point, you either have to delve into the computer system and program a little, or you have to pay a lot more money with these other sites. So at the end of it, I'm like, they must be making a killing. I'm not kidding. When I'm like counting out, okay, $20 per person, and if they have like the 10 million customers, that's 200 million. And then I'm like, wow, 200 million a month, you know, a month. I'm like, they're just richer than rich, you know, just pulling in a 10 million customers off of genealogy. So, wow. It's great though. I love it. I think genealogy, and you look at it on in a terms factor, as a canceling racism factor, it's amazing. My grandmother, for instance, in during her lifetime, she was a racist woman. She said many, I don't know, derogatories towards African Americans. And there was nothing we could do about it. You know, as grandchildren, we're just like, why does she do that? You know, how do we stop her? You know, she's the most embarrassing thing ever. She wouldn't stop being that type. And because she wouldn't stop, I am just so pleased with genealogy, because it goes back, and it finds her mixed in with Spaniards. It finds her mixed in, you know. So it finds her that she is not such a pure, what? Yeah. So that's nice. Anyway, so in a way, so the more that people know about who they are and where they come from, you know, it can really, gosh, maybe, you know, bang them on the head. You know, you're not a racist. Stop it. You actually are African American, or you came from Syria. You know, you're not a racist. Stop it. You know. So there. And then I'm like, well, there's something else I had to do with this program at the moment. At the very end of the day. So then I have my tinier one, my tinier program. Instead of everybody's all split out, I have them converge now to 120 megabytes, and that's a huge amount. And I'm like, well, where do I put this? You know, because I wanted to, like, share it with my brothers or whatever, and they can, you know, have their own copy. Where can it go? Right now, Ancestry is up to 75 megabytes with a stop limit. I think a lot of them, they can't handle these large files yet. And they're going to have to figure out a way, because they're just all, you know, once you catch into one of these lines, you're linked up back to the dinosaur age. So either another compression algorithm for it, so it's not such a huge file. They might have to write some special kind of compression or compressor. I don't know how that would work, but that is something to consider, because you can't have everybody running around with their 100 megabyte files running around saying, I'm king, I'm queen, and here we are, and we have our 100 megabyte files, and there's no place to put them, you know. So you can't even see the proof. You can't see the proof, darn it. So that's where I'm at right now. I'm trying to locate a place to, and I guess go public with it, because there's no reason not to be public. The more people know their lineage, the better. I don't think it's ever supposed to be something hidden, tucked away somewhere. You know, like I said, you know, if it gets at that little seed in their head that, oh, it doesn't matter, you are a Native American Indian, ha ha ha, you know, so if it gets at that little seed in their head and makes that racism click go away, you know, then it's worth it. You know, if each generation next, then it's worth it. Yeah. Okay, so then, Tantaria, was that it? Oh, I don't know. When it comes to, you know, I have so many things I have to say, but I think that really was mainly the genealogy part of this video. Yeah, I'll make a separate one. This was just about genealogy. And that's it. That wasn't that exciting, I'm sorry. I did watch one of Pyro314's videos recently, It was very interesting. It was very intriguing, and it drew me in, and I didn't understand what he was saying at all. He was talking about the imaginary, type of philosophy self and all this other stuff, and I'm like, I didn't get it. So now I have to go back and watch it again. But anyway, so yeah, sometimes that happens. And then what else happened? There was something major. Oh, I think I've figured out the spam freaking deal and how it occurs on the cell phone system. I think because my dad, he gets so much on his cell phone. He gets like every day he gets some stupid spammer phone message, and I'm like, where are they picking him up? And yesterday, you know, I made this vlog and I went out there and I typed in Rosalie on my actual site. I typed in the name Rosalie, and then this morning he gets a phone call, a spam phone call from Rosalie, Illinois. And I'm like, wait a minute, this is all too strange. So I'm thinking there's a web crawler robot thing, a crawler that goes to my site, that has me listed as a site to visit. So it goes to my site, and it picks up words that I write, and it grabbed out Rosalie, and found a phone number. It did a seek out to Rosalie, Illinois. It matched a city or a locality. And then it went and it found a spam number, because it probably had another list of spam numbers, and then it went equals to my father's phone number. So the web crawler goes out there, then matches to a location, and then with that location, a phone number that's a spam number, and then from that spam number goes to who's on the list. And for some reason, it went right around in a circle. A scary circle, too, because it feels like I'm being stalked, phone stalked. But so it went all the way around in a circle from what I wrote to being a phone call from there. Scary. It's a scary system. Ooh.